auto. Number of features to be considered. We have seen the example, the features vegan, non-veg, vegetarian. Similarly, that is one feature. That is one column. For us, for example, house prediction price, 80 columns we were using. Whereas in the car price prediction, maximum we are using 10 to 15 features or columns. So how many features it needs to select? That is auto. Depending upon the available data, depending upon the nature of the tree formation, we are giving the freedom to select by the Python code. Maximum depth. When the tree is growing, I said that this is a root, something like that. Depth they will be telling. What is the meaning of depth is, now this is one level of depth. This is one level of depth. Now the depth of the tree is 2. Human can tend to do only maximum depth of 5 to 10 kind of tree only. Beyond that, we are not capable of growing the tree, understanding the tree, whatever. But for the machine, we are trying to give maximum depth 100. Next, minimum sample split. So by default 2, what we are trying to tell is, for each and every node, the moment it starts taking decision, the branch, now randomly I'm giving one branch here. This is one branch. This is one branch. Could be n number of branches. Upon what condition it is going to split or it is going to take a branches is, we are trying to put a condition, minimum 10 samples fit into the category. When we will be splitting this, for example, being vegetarian and the home food liker, being vegetarian, outside food liker, whatever. So we are creating one column, the pattern of eating. One is vegetarian, another one is non-vegetarian, another one is vegan. Next, what we are trying to tell, each and every person of in a sample or instance, he may be liking to eat all the time home food. He may be liking to eat all the time outside food, something like that. Then this is called sample. This is one sample, one row constitutive sample. Then how many samples required for splitting is 10 we are trying to tell. Minimum sample leaves, how many sample leaves should be required? We are telling 4 samples. Now, next question, why I do set these all? You can ask me. I am also not aware of why I am setting. Randomly only I am giving 100, 100, auto, these all hyper parameters. So being a data scientist, what you're supposed to do is, you may need to run a loop. You can start building this estimators right from 10 to 100 or beyond 100 also. Similarly, you need to run a loop. Depth you can fix for better performance. Depth you can fix from 10 to beyond 100 also. Minimum sample split, you can start with 2 to 25 also you can do. Similarly, minimum leaf node 2 to 45 also you can keep. All the things we can control through loops. Then we can see the entire regression itself need to be executed under a loop. Then which kind of hyperparameters combination it gives the best results we can do. This is just like kit level way I am doing, just a kiddish way. What I am trying to tell, simply I am fixing 100 auto here, 100 here, randomly I am doing random forest, that's it. So the last one, random state equal to 1. Again, this related to number of records considered for each and every iteration, whether it is going to consist, it is going to consider without duplication or without replacement, or with duplication with replacement. What is the meaning is, we have record number 1, record number 2. When I grow a tree, we will be having 100 tree, one tree, second tree, something like that. So each and every tree, whether we are repeating the replacement or we are omitting, once if it is visited, never we will revisit, never we will consider. What kind of combination we would like to have? That's what random state. So based on that, it's working on. Just we are getting into random forest regression, not in depth. Once regression is done, fitting, then prediction, same code what we discussed yesterday, I'm revisiting, that's it. RMSC, R square. Now we are coming towards imputation. With that imputation, we are just doing, whether it is categorical, flow data, numerical data, we are trying to find out median value. That median value is substituted, but whenever the missing value have seen in the data. We discussed in the previous notebook forward filling algorithm and through the business knowledge how we started filling. That kind of approach I'm not doing here. Very simple notebook than the previous notebook. If you wish, we can understand each and every column. We can apply some art and creative work how the missing value need to be filled. Again, the improvement of this model is with the combination of imputation. It is the how we can improve further. I'm going to show certain value for RMSE, certain value for R square. If you say that it's not at all good, not appreciating, then yes, fine. We have some more scope. What is the scope is we can think of imputing in different methodologies, like what we did in the previous notebook. How the number of missing records are lesser than 10. In this notebook or data set, none of the column has less than 10. Every column, if you look at 9,000 record, 4,000 record, 5,000 records only missing. So in that case, what we can do? Definitely forward filling may not work out. I said, suggested that forward filling, backward filling will work out when the number of missing records are less than 25 something. But here it is huge in terms of thousands. Then we are trying with median. This is one method. Similarly, we can try with mean also. The same notebook, same code, you can try instead of median, mean. Let us see how that works, mean value. After mean, there is another way we can do. Mode. So all the three, mean, mode, median, we can try. For which imputation the algorithm performs better, we can fix that. So that is another suggestion. Maybe you can do this with mean and mode value. With the same notebook, with the imputation, only this part, with the imputation part alone. Tomorrow you can tell me what is the obtained result you have got. The same notebook I already have shared. And there is one mistake it is committed. I'll tell what mistake committed in that notebook. That you may need to recover it. If you couldn't recover, let me know. I'll send the notebook. So this, after the imputation, we are just confirming what are all the number of is null value. There is no null value. Everything is zero, filled. Now it is perfect data. So between the yesterday's discussion and today's discussion, only this cell is different. Nothing else is different. Rest all copy paste the same code we are trying to do. That's it. So this cell is for filling the missed value with, if at all, null value with median. I'm giving a small assignment or exercise for you all guys. Tomorrow you're supposed to do with this mode and mean. Then tell me what is the RMS way, RMS value you have obtained and R square value you have obtained. Is that okay? Girish, Suma, could you hear me?
Yes, ma'am, yes.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes, yes, Lakshmi garu.
Yeah. Now. Yeah, 1 minute. Please, sir.
I'm in a meeting. I started on the water. Before 7, always working. Okay, 7. Not available. Not available. Then it will be completing by 8:45. Tomorrow we can meet.
Tomorrow, I can just show it as
available. Yeah, yeah, definitely. Yes, first stage we can finish. But,
now we are doing encoding process. All the categorical variables do encoding, get dummies. So with that, what we are doing, encoding process, like how we did in the previous notebook, same only we are doing here. The next, what we are doing, separating input and output features. So price supposed to be a test parameter or test variable. We need to drop it from the complete data set. Then we need to check that the price parameter or price variable is normally distributed or not. We are trying to apply log transformation and histogram plot we are trying to do. This is not at all normally distributed, highly skewed. Skewed means one side it is biased. So whereas after applying log, yes, we could see a little bit resemblance with bell curve. So because of this confidence, we can proceed with model building. So what is a mistake I committed in your notebook is this line will not be there. Simple, this line is available in the previous notebook. You need to do y2 is equal to np dot log y2. Because actually highest error I have obtained, after that I started fixing this by 7 o'clock only. That's why delay today. So what I am supposed to do is, after this, that log transformation I have not considered. So only plotting I did with your notebook. This one line I missed it. Because of that, RMSE value highly deviated. It was around in your notebook 4000, 3000, something like that. I was puzzled, then I fixed this bug by 7 o'clock only. Y2 equal to np dot log y2. Now only really we are applying this normal distribution upon the variable y2. Y2 is a price, that's it. We started splitting the price column we assigned to y2. See, this is the line we are taking out from the entire data set, we are giving to y2. Then the usual procedure. Any data science data model we do, it is mandatory to have four variables. One is x prime, x test, y prime, y test. These four. Then followed by that one and all different, that's it. But these four kind of splitting will happen. That is the predominant role of train underscore test underscore split. This function does this job. What we are doing? Nothing we are doing. X data, Y data. Y is our predictive variable. X is independent variable. Test size we are giving 70%. If you wish, you can give that 80% also or 75% also. If you want to give 75%, 0.75 we need to put. That 0.75 signifies training data set size. 0.25 signifies testing data set. Now 80 is 80. If you put 0.8, that signifies 80% of training data, 20% of testing data. This is the thumb rule we discussed long back. Now let's move to the next. For this baseline model we are doing for reference only. Again, I mentioned this baseline model is not at all required. If you wish, you can use any model we build. It should be much better than the baseline model. This is the thumb rule. That's it. NP dot mean y test. For example, if you are writing a research paper publication, if you want the sometime, it is mandatory to use baseline model. Even for classification, there is a baseline model that we will be discussing a little bit later. But for industrial purpose, anything you do for real-time application, this baseline model is not at all required. So we are taking mean value among all the y, that price data. This is the mean value. That mean value we are repeating for entire test. Then after repetition, we are not doing any linear or random forest. Simply we are going means for RMSE value. RMSE value 0.14. Then any model which we build, it's supposed to be better than this. That's it. Now we are coming towards linear regression with imputed data. The very first function, linear regression, fit intercept equal to true. Again, I say it is up to your choice. If you wish, you can use. Otherwise also, it does the job. Next, fitting X train and Y train. It compares the model performance. Then using this prediction, we are going for predicting X test value, then it gives some value, Y value it gives. Then the given Y value with the original Y test compared to the subtraction, then mean square, the same procedure, 0.08. Then R squared value, the same procedure, X test, Y test we are submitting. Whatever that X test, Y test, it will start predicting some value. That with that value, we are trying to find out the difference. Then this is a formula, just a formula, R square formula and RMSE formula. So this is the obtained value. Now RMSE value is going very closer towards zero. You can notice 0.08 we have obtained. Similar, same data set we are trying with random forest. Same parameters, hyperparameters, I am not changing anything. Without changing only, we need to fix only, then we can compare the model. If we are trying to change, then we cannot compare the model. Then whatever we are applying with the linear regression, previous random forest, the same we need to imitate. if you are doing with multiple loop, changing this parameter, this parameter, this parameter, similarly, we need to do here also. Only with the fixed hyperparameter, we can compare. If we keep changing, we cannot compare, that's it. The same we are doing predicting RMS value. If you look at this value closer, which is doing all the time better is random forest only, 0.06 with imputation. Without imputation also, for random forest performed much better than linear regression. So we cannot predict. For the syllabus wise, we are learning linear regression, but the random forest is doing much better than linear regression. So any given prediction model, we need to try with lot many method. Again, I give you a recap. For the prediction, we can use Marsh algorithm. I'll come back what is Marsh algorithm. We have discussed linear regression. Next, we have discussed or entered into random forest. These three. There is one more, KNN, SVM, support vector machine. These all we can use. Anytime, if we are in the position to write a research publication or business logic for prediction model, we supposed to try all the five models, which one gives better performance, that we need to carry out. Not only five model, each and every model, we can do certain improvement, that is hyperparameter tuning, this is one approach, boosting, another approach, bagging, another approach. So we may need to try, then regularization, another approach. So these are all the approaches we can apply. Although we use different model, further we can try how much best accuracy we can give or how best we can reduce the error, RMSE value that we can do. When to use Marsh is the question mark. This Marsh, when we can use is, we have independent variables. We have discussed both in the house price and the car price, independent variable. Whereas in the house price, we had more than 80 or at least 75 variables as an independent variable. In the car, probably 25 variables. If you look at in these two combination, how it available, it's a purely combination of numerical and categorical. Equally available, I can say, or unequal, whatever, but most of the variables are categorical. Then we can use is, if it is of only numerical, we need to use Marsh algorithm. Most of the independent variables are, if it is of numerical variable, none of other algorithm scientists recommends to go with. They are recommending us to go with only Marsh algorithm. This only does better. By the time we should not choose this, or you can try this, we no need to choose this, we no need to choose this, we no need to choose. If at all you are lucky, you may get better performance with this model. If not, Marsh is the suggested algorithm. If the independent variables all are of numerical data, if the moment multiple categorical data comes, we need to go with either one of these models. That's it. Yeah. Any questions so far now with this? May I hear from you, Mr. Girish, Ms. Suma?
Hello.
I think your kid is responding to me than you.
Hello.
Yeah, Mr. Abhay.
Hello.
Yeah, any questions so far now?
Shall we proceed?
My mom.
Yeah, tomorrow. A small assignment or exercise you're supposed to do for me with this modification, that imputation I did only with the median. You're supposed to do with mean and you're supposed to do with mode. And you need to show me the comparative chart, R square value, RMS value for all the three. I did this, you are doing these two. all the of comparative chart for all the three, you may need to consolidate and send me. One is RMSC, another one is R square. That's it. This is a small stepping stone. Then slowly we will move on to, I have appeared for one of the hackathon. So that hackathon data set that I will share as a little bit major assignment, you may need to do with the prediction model with that data set. That is movie review data set. With that, you can start with your project. Then tomorrow onwards, I'll be moving on to logistic regression or classification model. Kannan sir, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, sir, with this I wanted to complete today. If you have any stuff to be communicated, you can proceed, please.
Yeah, actually I wanted to talk about some use cases today. Okay,
sir.
And also for the benefit of especially Abhay and Suma, did you show them the actual decision tree anytime?
No, sir. Okay. Today only I'm starting a bit information about trees.
Okay. So, Abhay, you are saying
something?
Just for me?
Sir?
No, I'm sorry. The signal is not clear. I'm not able to hear the audio properly. Last 5 minutes alone.
No,
okay. Last 5 minutes, nothing happened. Only assignment.
Okay, Abhay, the voice is clear for everyone else. Probably it's your side.
Yes, sir. If you wish to communicate anything, you can do.
Logistic
regression also I can start with.
No. I want to share something. Let me share my screen now.
Sure, sir.
Yeah.
Shall I switch off or what I supposed to do?
You don't have to do anything. I'm just sharing my screen. So you don't have to do anything.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so first I want to show three diagrams from decision tree. Okay, so this is a normal decision tree. This is actually a program that identifies or predicts that diabetes is present or not in individuals. Okay, so let me open this. So this is a decision tree which has the complete depth. Okay. So this is a simple decision tree. Okay. So a decision tree has multiple parameters. So obviously you can see that the outcome is whether the person has diabetes or not. That is the outcome. There are only two target variables. But to compute that, it is going through a whole lot of processing cycles. So this could be an overkill. This could be an overkill. And it may also mean that Your accuracy may be low, your performance in terms of speed is going to be very poor and all. So normally what they do is, they do what is called as pruning, okay? Let me give you a small example. Let us assume that in this diagram itself, let us say this path has 60% of the samples and this path has 40% of the samples, okay? So from here, let us say I have one branch going to 38%. The remaining 2% has multiple depth actually. So to just to compute 2% of the samples, we are going through n number of deep decision making process. So that is actually a wasted effort. So what they do is they try to limit the number of depth. The amount of levels that you have is limited using multiple parameters. One could be flat depth presentation. Okay, so for example, I can say, give me a maximum depth of 4 or give me a maximum depth of 5. So here, if you see the depth, I can see calculate here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. The depth is 15 here. So if it is going to only address a few number of samples for 15th depth, it is going to be wasted. So one of the options is to use a limitation on the depth, or in each of the leaf node, what could be the minimum number of samples that you can accommodate? For example, I'm saying I want to have at least 2% of samples should be there in each of the leaf nodes. So that way you can restrict. Okay, so let me show you another diagram. The same problem, but the depth is reduced. So here you can see the depth is only 4. So here you get sometimes better accuracy and also simple calculation and the performance would be better. Okay, so in any of the decision tree, you have to find out which is the optimum parameter that you want to choose first. Okay, so here we are choosing glucose level is less than 127.5 or greater. Okay, so if it is true, it comes here. If it is false, it goes here. Okay, so then we have the body mass index, the age. Okay, so this decision tree and random forest can optimize these numbers also. Suppose I have age value, so it can also optimize where I can cut off the age so that I can have better samplings. Okay, so like that. So that is what she was trying to say. So she will be delving into this more detail later. So next diagram is another of the same thing. Okay, so the previous one was depth of 3. This is the depth of 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the depth of 4. And the previous one is depth of 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay. So I think when we cover decision tree and random forest in more detail, we'll come back to this. Okay, just want to make sure some of the points are very clear. Okay. Any questions here so far?
Oh, this is very clear. Thank you.
Okay. Fine, sir.
All right. So what I wanted to discuss is after learning this machine learning, so what are some of the advantages that you get in terms of career switching or career path? Okay, so if you look from a domain perspective, so what are the common domain or verticals where the jobs are present? So I can say one of the domain can be retail. So can you tell me some more examples of domain?
Banking.
Manufacturing. Since you are with the Tavant, you were saying it.
No, my name is Tavant Longman.
Okay. What else? You can remember birth. B for banking, I for insurance.
Okay.
R for retail, T for telecom, and H for healthcare. Okay. Manufacturing and transportation, e-governance. Okay, lot more, but these are the primary things. Okay, oil and gas. Okay. So we are talking about these domains because this is where you have a lot of jobs, this is where a lot of projects are present, and also the salary and all those things are very, very high here. So generally these are the target areas. Okay, so we want to understand any one of these domains and see what are the typical use cases that are present in these domains. Okay, so by far the maximum place, the place where maximum number of requirements come, is the banking domain. Okay, so banking and financial domain is very, very important. So one of the gaps that is created when we train for these programs, for example, you're getting trained for data science, machine learning, etc. Just like when you take a university degree and you come out to the industry, you see a big gap. What you learned is not same as what you're going to see in the office. Okay. Same, even our trainings do the same thing. Okay. So for example, madam was discussing some of the steps that are involved for predicting certain things. Okay. So beyond what we do, there are a lot of other things that are done for, probably because the data is coming from multiple sources or the data is huge and has some issues with the source systems. So you may have to do lot more than just handling missing values and outlier detection and removal, and all those things are there. But beyond that, you may even have to change some of the file formats, some of the field delimiters have to be addressed like that. Okay. And also their core objective. So here we are learning. So we just say, okay, you have to do this, you have to do that. That's good. That's going to get you the result. But let us say you're actually in the business, in the banking. Okay. So now let us take a simple example. A person is applying for a loan. Okay. Or let us say you want to calculate what is the optimum interest you can give for a fixed deposit. So obviously, if you give a very high percentage, you can get more customers, but you may not make much profit. And also there are some regulations that are there. You cannot have a very big margin between yourself and the next bank. Okay. So because of all these regulations and other things, we have to optimize the interest rates according to certain formula and also based on the past data and the current relevant fundamentals. Okay. So let us assume that I calculated some percentage for FD and it came to 15.5%. If we just take that and apply, then we are going to run into big losses, because for fixed deposit, normally we give 7%, 6% like that. So we know exactly what should be the boundaries, what is the upper boundary and lower boundary. So it has to lie between those two points. So in banking and all the actual scenarios, we will not stop until we get what we want. Okay. So we will not think, okay, we got within set sum of error equal to this much. Okay, let's go on with it. We cannot do that. So we need to see what is the right thing, and if it is not coming, what are we doing wrong, or what else can we do to go there? Okay. So we have a clear target. Okay. So most of the time there'll be a target that is there that you have to achieve. So let us look at some of the use cases and see what could be possible steps involved in doing these things. Okay. So always after the learning, you have to interpolate and ask some questions. So what else could be there? So you can always take some data samples, or you can take some programs from the GitHub, or look at some YouTube or Udemy videos and look at processes or programs that are dealing with all the details. For example, in banking industry, for example, HSBC, what they do is they are doing linear regression. They don't simply apply a single linear regression technique. The same linear regression technique, they apply in multiple phases, okay, with the different hyperparameters and all those things. So they do a lot of trial and error to achieve the results. So that is very, very important. That is what we practically do. Okay. So let us look at this Excel spreadsheet and see what are some of the important. Okay. So let me first pose this question and then we will go to the sheet. Okay. So now we are talking about banking and financial sector. Okay. So what are the possible use cases where we can use machine learning to an advantage?
Fraud detection.
We can do fraud detection.
Okay. Fixing the loan amount.
Yeah. So we need to fix the loan amount.
Calculating CIBIL scores.
Call it credit scoring. Okay. Yeah. Okay, Girish, can I have 3 points from you? Next, I'll come to Abhay.
Give me some time, sir.
What is it? She took the easy one, sir.
Yeah, I guess so.
I tell you, credit card promotion, debit card.
No. You should not say. You are the expert here.
Lakshmi madam is helping me, sir. Count two.
Okay. So I'll give the chance to Abhay first, because he is a free newbie and Girish already has a lot of experience. Abhay, you can tell some 3 important use cases here.
For different kinds of loans, like house loan or whichever loans we can.
No, but that is all different products. Machine learning has got nothing to do with it. Okay.
I'm not able to think of anything right now. I'll just.
Spending patterns, we can predict.
Excellent. Spending patterns. So based on the spending patterns, you can give them different products, loans, all those things. Okay. Okay. So every industry has one two common things. One is the customer segmentation. Yes. Okay. So what type of customer will give us more business? Like, will it be rural customer or urban customer? Is it going to be business owner or salaried employee? Who is going to give us more revenue? For example, if you go to some banks, there may be one customer who is investing like more than 50% of the entire bank income, whereas 1,000 other people may just contribute some 10%. So that's called as a high value customer. So customer segmentation is very important, and also customer churn. What is customer churn?
Someone who's leaving.
Right. Yeah, right. So for example, he's with HDFC Bank. He somehow got bored with HDFC, or he's not liking the policies or the way they treat him, or maybe the charges are very high. Okay. So he goes to Axis Bank or ICICI Bank. So that is called customer churn. Okay. So when customer churn happens, first of all, what we lose is we lose a customer and all his business. Normally, when a customer leaves, he normally takes away his close friends and relatives also. They don't go there, man. That's a useless bank. You start with Axis Bank. They give you a coffee fee, etc. Okay. So customer churn also costs the money that you have invested on the advertisement. To get one customer, you would have advertised some amount. Okay. So you put banners, you give different kinds of advertisements, so that all that amount is getting wasted. Okay. So if you don't look at the exit door, then you have to spend more time on the entry door. You have to invite more customers. You have to canvas more like that. Okay. So customer churn is one of the very important industry. Okay. So now let us go to this list. I collected a big list of use cases. So as far as the job is concerned, one of the best jobs you can take in terms of machine learning and data science is actually banking. The pay is also very high, but once you work with one bank, you can also go to other banks and work on similar line of business or domain. Okay. So these are certain things. Okay. So fraud detection. Another thing is cross-selling and upselling. Suppose you go to a pie store, or you go to one agency that's selling a fridge, TV and all. So you plan to go and buy a refrigerator. They're not going to leave you just with the refrigerator. They'll give you, sir, this has a very good deal, sir. You can take this. You get 4,000 rupees discount, sir. So you come back with a LCD TV, fridge and washing machine and all those things. So that is called as cross-selling. Okay. So you come for one thing, they try to sell you more things. Or they say you want to have a budget of 10,000 for the fridge. They make you buy an 18,000 rupee fridge. That means that is upselling. Okay. The same applies to any industry. So that requires a lot of data analytics and machine learning, so that you can identify this person is capable of buying this much and his normal annual budget of spending is this much. So definitely we can make him buy. So you can't bark at the wrong tree. Okay. Suppose a person is very stingy and he is not going to buy. Whatever you do or whatever you tell him, he's not going to buy. So cross-selling and upselling has to be applied only to the targeted customers. Okay. So finding the targeted customer is one of the most important in machine learning task in any business. Okay. All right. So that's one thing. We talked about customer segmentation, risk management analysis. Okay. So if you have seen the news, lot of banks are almost wiped out because they made some risky deals. They gave loans to some of the biggest tycoons in India, and they disappeared from the face of the planet. And now the banks are in trouble. Okay. So you could always find out risky customers and risky processes and protocols and avoid them at any cost. Okay. So this will always go in hand with the compliance and regulatory rules. So if you combine these things, then you can always play it safe. Okay. So instead of being greedy to get some additional money, you can actually play it safe and also be in the safe zone. Okay. So credit scoring is another important thing, and recommendation engine. Okay. So recommendation engine is definitely very, very important. We can recommend the right products for the right customers. So this again involves a lot of data analysis. So can you give me an example of a tangible recommendation engine that you see very often?
May I?
Yeah, please.
Amazon, Prime, Netflix, yeah. LinkedIn, yeah. Facebook, everywhere it starts recommending. It recommends some new friends based on my locality, based on my profession, similarity, it starts recommending LinkedIn.
Exactly, exactly. So she used the term similarity. So recommendation is primarily based on similarity measures. So suppose I am buying something on Amazon, okay? So it will always recommend me. People who bought this also bought this product. So they try to bundle up products. So they know that because these two items are always bought together. So recommendation engine is a very, very important component of e-commerce, retail, and all kinds of banking and other applications as well. And this is a very important thing, anti-money laundering. AML means anti-money laundering. So in every bank, there's a important division or branch called as AML. So they have to, because if they don't take care of this, some government agency will come and try to catch them, okay? So normally what will happen is, apart from fraud and other things, money laundering is something like a soft fraud. It is sometimes it can be tagged as a legitimate transaction or business, but it is actually an illegal thing, okay? So it's something like an insider trading that happens in the stock exchange. There's a lot of money laundering that happens. Maybe a branch employee can come with some black money and wash it and all those things. Okay. So anti-money laundering is a very, very important branch. And customer churn. So loan, it actually talks about two things. One is whether I should give a loan to this customer or not based on all the parameters. So suppose I want to create an engine or a program to identify whether I should give a loan or not, you can always look at your old loans, whether the person has paid or not. Based on that, you can identify features like his salary, number of children, whether he's married. Like that, you can take all the parameters, all the features. Madam will be talking more about the features and the feature engineering process. Okay. So right now, yes, based on the loan, there are two things. One is whether he's a good customer or bad customer. How we know it? We do not know about that customer, but we know about similar customers in the past who have defaulted. So using those customers' signature patterns, you can apply the same thing to this customer and you can find out whether you should give or not. So if you're planning to give, what should be the loan amount? Let's say he's asking for 10 crores. Should you give 10 crores? Maybe he's eligible only for 1 crore or 50 lakhs. So you have to give only that much. Okay, so that also ML helps a lot. Interest rate optimizer, which talked about for different products, what should be the ideal rate of interest. And portfolio optimization, rebalancing, these are all fund management and portfolio management, which can be including mutual funds, lot of other investment plans. Okay, and also lifetime value prediction. So what would be the value of that particular customer related to a specific product, okay, for his lifetime, okay. And also, this is a major one, investment prediction, okay. So let us say I want to get some investors, okay. I can slog and try hard and get some 100 investors. Instead, I can get one very good investor. Let's say one investor is there who is ready to invest $1 billion. So what the banks will do is they will study him. They know that he's an investor. He's keen on investing. So they will study him. They will first of all understand what is his mindset, what he wants to actually do it. Then they'll study about his personal habits, whether he's going to a golf course, where his daughter is studying. So they will try to have some connection with them and make similar interests. There is a lot of things that they do outside the business realm to get such a big investor. Okay. So for all these data analytics is used. So social media data also is actually queued into the mainstream master data management to make decisions and strategies to make the big investors to invest. Obviously, no, I don't want 1,000 small investors. I just want to catch one big fish. Okay. So, of course, we also want to have more investors and more investment, but there's always a 80-20 rule that you have to follow. 80% of investment comes from less than 20% of the investors. So try to focus on that 20% investors. Okay. Personalized marketing is again very important. So they will send you messages, they'll send you emails, they'll say, okay, so now you are a family who wants to buy a scooter. They will send you a deal for scooter. Okay, buy this, we are having a scooter mela. But they won't send it to a person who is owning a Mercedes or a Audi, because they know that he's not going to buy a scooter. So the personalized marketing is very, very meaningful. Otherwise, they will think that you are just spamming them. Okay, if I get daily messages for buying an Audi or a BMW, I will think these guys are crazy, right? So
may I say one point?
Yes, please. Yeah.
Yeah, and if we target a unwanted or not the right audience, then the digital pay per click, digital promotions, they may need to lose a lot of money. Penalization will become more for the promoters. So that they need to find out the right audience. Although it looks like 0.5 rupees, when it goes more, then the cost of that advertisement will become more.
Correct. Okay. Yeah, so exactly. So suppose yesterday I sent my mail. I wanted to send some training program to colleges. I took some 3,000 mails and sent to all the 3,000 mail days. 70% of them bounced back because that database was very old. And out of the remaining, they started firing me. Please do not send such emails. Finally, I got some 3 or 4 leads out of 1,800. But today morning, I got a list of current colleges with their latest, because my old list had bsnl.com, bsnl.com, all those IDs were there, pretty old. Okay, some were even older than that Hyder Ali regime actually. But today morning I sent a mail which had only 200 leads, out of which I got already some 10 leads, 10 contacts. Okay, so for every marketing effort that you do, there is a cost. So a lot of times you will see message blast or email blast and all, they are worthless, because for every mail that you send, there's a cost factor that is there. Okay, because you will have to pay to the marketers, you have to pay to the prospecting team, etc. So, and also the more spam you send, the more you will be blocked and more your rating will go down. Okay, so be it the biggest of the banks, it is always better to only send to the targeted audience. This is where a lot of companies go wrong. They try to spam the entire universe and then wonder why they are not getting business. Okay. And then we have the compliance and regulatory requirements. So this we may not be able to comprehend immediately, but that is one of the areas very, very critical to the banks. Okay. So there are different standards. Basel standard is there. They have Sarbanes-Oxley compliance. And RBI compliance, like that, there are many compliance each bank has to follow, failing which they can be penalized. They may also lose their contract. Okay. And they will also lose to the competition if they don't comply to those rules. Okay. So compliance requirements is very essential, but normally that requires a lot of qualifications, a lot of certifications to work on. So normally we will not be dealing with that. So we may not have to focus on that very much. Risk modeling is definitely one of the important areas, but again, we may not get a chance to work on it because that is purely for financial experts. Even if they give you the best data in a platter to us, we may not be able to make any sense out of it. Okay. So this requires a lot of domain knowledge. So this is for veterans who are in the bank for 20 years, 30 years. They know exactly what they're talking about. So mostly we will not be working on it. Customer support, definitely yes, because this is actually linked to a lot of things like IVR, the chatbots, NLP, and customer fulfillment services. So if you take how a list of things that you can do to increase your business, perhaps customer support comes last. But that is the only thing that is left with us in the current scenario, because every bank tries to fight with every other bank in all possible ways. So they have already taken advantage of all the other edges. what is left is the customer support or poor customer satisfaction level. So a lot of, for example, if you ever made a call to IRCTC or BSNL, you would know how great the customer support is. Okay, sometimes they simply say thanks for calling us and they'll keep the phone down. Okay, and especially if your internet is cut, BSNL is cut, it normally takes 3 or 4 days for it to resume or reinstate it. So that is why a lot of people shifted from BSNL to Airtel and Vodafone for their broadband. Okay, so customer support is one of the key things that they can actually work on to increase their revenue and sales. Okay, and obviously sales analysis is there, which is part of the marketing and campaigning and prospecting teams, and lending and transactional. So lending is actually a bank lends its money to other big organizations at a higher interest rate to earn revenue for them. Because if the bank is just keeping the money in their vaults, then they're going to lose it in the sense that they don't get anything out of it. So no bank holds their money on their premises. They always lend it to other banks or other organizations at a higher rate. So it may be mutual funds, it may be some construction work or infrastructure work, anything, but they don't keep it on the vaults. Okay, so how they can lend or how they can invest in other avenues or channels is very, very important. So that is an ongoing thing. So you will have to use time series analysis. For example, you are trying to understand the mutual funds, you will know how haphazard the graph goes. Okay, so we need to actually understand that. So hedge fund is also one of the things that, especially in US and all, it's a very important area. And trade settlement. So if you look at banking, there are different divisions. Let me list the different divisions. Then it will make sense to understand those points. Okay. So normally, so I worked on a project in a company called Mysis, so which is completely a banking solution. So our 6 focus areas initially we focused on was profitability. So whatever we do, we have to focus on profitability. Then current account, saving account, then credit card, loans, foreign exchange, okay, and deposits. Okay, so like that we have different areas. Okay, so some of people, they work on different branches, like anti-money laundering. Okay, there's a department called fraud, then there's a department called big industries. Okay, so commercial banking, so they only lend to big industries. They always deal with the different big corporates. Okay, big industries and big corporates. Okay, so like that, one of the key things that we have to understand is, if you want to take a job in banking or financial domain, you need to become comfortable with these terminologies, and you have to understand the domain. Okay, there are a lot of documents out there to understand how the bank operates and what are the different departments inside it. Okay, so if you there's a general ledger is there, okay, then accounts receivable, like that, there are different departments. So you need to understand that they are just not current account and saving account and credit card alone. There are at least some 30 departments within each bank. Okay, so some cater to individuals, some cater to organizations, some cater to bigger investors, like that. Okay, and some of them would be on a macroeconomic level. They want to understand the strategies, what is the climate in that particular country in terms of economic trend. Okay, so those things they will be studying in detail. Okay, so trade settlements also would be one of those things, which is includes different trade practices and complying with other co-branches or co-banks like that. Okay, so real-time analysis is a general terminology that talks about taking the real-time data and analyze. Okay, so it can be part of any of the other domains. So out of these, treasury is one more thing. Treasury, which includes customer retention management and spot transaction, etc. Okay, So you don't have to focus on everything. So that is why what we have done is we have numbered these things according to the priority. So these are the 16 important areas that we focus. Okay. So I'll send this list after making some more changes. So what you do is, I would personally recommend you to take banking and financial analytics, because that is where you can get a lot of visibility and a lot of exciting projects. And also the number of job vacancies are also very high. Okay. So first is this one, and then you have the retail, e-retail or the e-commerce industry. So this is where you have to focus. Okay. So if you want to focus on these areas, you need to understand the terminology. You need to work with these algorithms. You take these algorithms, you can download from GitHub or any place, and then go through all the steps. Okay. So all the steps you have to do. And that way you will be able to be very confident in terms of what you have to do if you are given a problem. In some of the interviews, they will directly ask you, suppose I make you the decision maker for this particular project, how would you go about in creating an engine for identifying cross-selling opportunities for a particular product like loans, okay? So loans means, instead of giving a small loan, you can give a big loan, so that anyway, whether you are giving a small loan or big loan, it's going to be 36 months or more. So you may as well give a bigger loan so that every month you get more interest. Okay. So always cross-selling or upselling is a very important thing. Fraud detection. So you can, instead of focusing on many domains, focus on one domain and understand the internals of these things, and also the terminologies that play a major role here, so that you can become very, very confident when you face the interview. Okay, so that is one of the things that I'm also doing for the interns that we are having in our office. Okay, so they are currently working on a workshop mode. Every day they come and spend 8 hours here in these projects, actually. Okay, so that is what I wanted to tell you. I wanted to actually go through one of the use cases, but we may not have much time for today to go through it. So maybe some other day we'll take it up, or madam will take that some other time, so that you can understand the internals of the algorithms as well. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Your use cases really added more value to think in vertical direction.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you. No problem. So, Girish, Abhay, Suma, any questions so far?
Sir.
Yeah.
Let them complete the question session. Then I wanted to give few instructions. That's it.
Okay. Yeah, Girish, any questions?
No, sir. No. I'll go.
Abhay?
No
questions, sir?
No, it's clear. No questions.
Okay, all right. Suma, Suma or her representative? Her kid is the representative for her.
Actually, they're supposed to work on mean and one more is mode. For that, tomorrow exercise, day after tomorrow, I'll be giving the same house price prediction. Someone else GitHub link, Kaggle link. So the way that particular data analyst, how he or she, I don't know, looks at the data, how the travel of that prediction goes. So that you may need to walk through and understand and give a very slight presentation, maybe 10 minutes presentation sufficient. Subsequent, I'll be moving with a different algorithm. Tomorrow we start with logistic regression. I don't know how much we can complete, and daily it will go on. But you all supposed to work from the backward. So linear regression, then I'll give that hackathon code, hackathon data set, which I participated in the hackathon. So that I will give you. That is one of the prediction model I did with Mars, KNN, and random forest and linear regression. I think so, only 4 algorithm, maybe one or more, that's it. So you can try with linear regression for the same data. Later on, we can discuss what is the way you are doing and what is the obtained result and what I am having, something like that we discuss. Then similarly for everything, now condenser shared PMA diabetic data. So that code also I'm having. So that I, decision tree code I'm having, that I will share with you. And one more thing, random forest algorithm suits for prediction as well as classification. That is only one algorithm behaves in both ways. prediction way as well as classification way. So for that, the base is decision tree. Whenever we wanted to go deeper into random forest, the decision tree understanding is essential. I need to thank Kannan sir for sharing some snapshots of decision tree. So the decision tree, random forest, both are white box model. What is white box is, see, this through coding, we can able to get what internally happening, how split is happening, how many nodes, what is the depth, something like that we can able to understand. So that upon that display, we can take some decision, what way we can tune, how we can change, something like that we can take decision. Whereas linear regression, logistic regression, we can't even understand what exactly internally going on. Those are all black box models people used to call. This is one of the excellent white box model. Random decision tree is the base for random forest. That's why random forest always is called as ensemble, because underneath one more algorithm is working. That's why ensemble, multiple algorithms are combined together in building a model, then it is ensemble algorithm. So as from now onwards, today onwards, small to the major project, slowly we will be moving on. So sufficient foundation has been given, I feel so. If not, you need to raise with your questions or doubts so that I can spend some more, half an hour or 1 hour, either myself or Kannan sir, to clarify your doubts. Then we can move further. That's it.
Okay.
Yeah. Nice. Do you recover the notebook that y2 equal to np dot log of y2? I forgot to give that line. Should I give forward the notebook? I will send it. The moment session is over, then I'll send that the correct notebook which I'm using right now.
Okay, that would be helpful. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, any other questions? If not, we'll close the meeting and we'll regroup tomorrow.
Okay, that's fine.
All okay, right, thank you.
Yes, see you all. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Bye. 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 Suma and Girish. Yeah.
Bye, everyone.